Everybody ready? They played great. We didn't play very well. It was similar performance, I think, to when we came in here last year. I thought the beginning of the game really obviously was the difference. They completely dominated it. We had no answer. We had no answer for anybody for a long time. But I think you got to give them credit. They played great. They seem to be playing better and better. We're still young, and we were shell shocked early on. But at least we hung in there. We hung in there and we played, and we got better in the second half.
We'll take questions for Kevin Currier first, and get him off the stage. Any questions for Kevin Currier, please?
Cal Perry has these last few games talked about trying to let Scal play the way that makes the most sense for him, let him shoot jump shots and hope he'll block some shots. When he does those things, how does he change them going forward?
Well, he's, that makes a huge difference. That's another weapon that they have. He played really well tonight. And then he talked about Willis, mentioned Willis's jump shots. We do that. We practice that going in. I think our guys got sped up. We talked about that, and the Scal certainly was a factor. And obviously, he's one of the best players in the country. And unfortunately for us, he kind of started to really find himself tonight.
Kim, how efficient do you think Kentucky was in terms of coming down court and getting points?
Well, I thought they were very efficient, and part of that was we were inefficient, but part of that, I thought they really, really executed well. I thought they did a great job. Obviously, I just think Ulis just controls the game. He just controls it. He just takes over the game. Not just scoring, but playmaking, and tonight he made shots, which he makes them anyway. I just think he just controls the basketball game. He's a major, major weapon, I think.
Kim, can you talk a little bit more about, I know, or Kim, the other day on the teleconference you talked
about. I forget my name too. Okay.
Well, that's old age here, so, but.
We're probably about the same age.
Probably. You talk about the
receiver. You got more facial hair than that.
For today. You talked about that you can see Kentucky kind of defining roles and accepting roles. How much does the way Willis has played, from what you've seen, factor into that?
Well, we watched a lot of tape, obviously, on him. And, you go back, we watched him play UCLA and some other games. And I just, I just think that, and I don't know if this has happened in the last three games, it seems to me it has. They kind of understand what their strengths are. Now, we did do a good job on Willis, but, we finally started switching stuff and making it a little bit more difficult on him. But, when you got a guy that size and can pop like that and shoot it, that creates problems for you. So, I think he's definitely been going to be a big factor.
Coach, when these losses seem to keep adding up, is it difficult to keep your guys mentally into it? And how do you guys approach the rest of the year from here on out?
Well, we just kind of go one game at a time. I mean, obviously this is a disappointing performance because, not because we got beat by 34 points or whatever it ended up being. It's for me, it's just disappointing that we didn't start off better and we didn't. And I don't want to say we didn't compete. I just think we got run over by a truck, early in the game, and it took us a while to get back up. But I didn't. You got to give them credit. They played well, and we didn't. Our youth shows sometimes, and when it does, then we get to going off like we're going to score 16 points in one possession, and that's all you're not. I mean, but this game was from the start. I thought they played with an incredible amount of energy. It reminded me a lot of last year's game, I'll be honest with you, when we came in here. I just thought that for whatever reason, they were really, really energized.